Okay, so what we're doing today is the one thing I was promised we wouldn't be doing. We are dropping the engine on this E30. The first and most standard option most people use is a cherry picker. Slides under the car, hoists out, remove the engine. That's not gonna work in our case because for one, our garage is too small, and two, we're on an incline, so we don't need an engine and a cherry picker rolling down the driveway.
No.
Option two is a gantry, which is basically two huge metal poles with a beam across the top, same concept, hoist the engine out. Those take up a whole bunch of room and they're insanely expensive. We've come up with sort of a cheap hillbilly DIY thing that we're doing, and we think it'll work, and it's the lowest cost and the least amount of room taken up in our garage.
So essentially what we're going to be doing is utilizing the hitch on our truck. So this will work if you also have a hitch on your car, but the first thing you're going to need is going to go right on like that. There we go. Safety first. I'm almost there, actually.
Not today.
All right, so we have this Harbor Freight pickup truck crane now mounted to the hitch step. Typically, this goes mounted inside of the bed, but the reason we're doing it to the hitch is so that way we can back up to the car in the garage here, and then we can use the boom arm of this guy to grab the engine, pick it up, and take it out. Come on. Get in there. Don't pinch my fingers, Ashley.
Come on, Javier, don't pinch my fingers.
So one other thing that we realized is that this thing has a lot of wobble and play, and a lot of the weight is gonna be being forced down here on the truck hitch. We definitely wanna beef it up a little bit, so we also bought this trailer jack. So we're gonna take this trailer jack and hook it up here just to give us a little bit more support, if you will. Ta-da!
Ta-da! Another expensive item from Harbor Freight.
Let's see. Here you go, Ashley. We did a little bit of an upgrade. We essentially got rid of the hand crank and we're working on getting our wench mounted properly. I've got one bolt, but I need to figure out how to mount another bolt. Then I also have these chains here to hold it in place to keep it nice and steady. So once we get this situated, we should be getting closer to giving this thing a test run. All right. But we have another issue. The cable has to go through there. However, you can't really take this apart. So I'm thinking, Ashley, that we just maybe just grind a notch there and that'll fall, the cable can fall right into the little spool part in there. What do you think?
Good idea.
Here we go. Notch there. Plenty of clearance right there. And we should be good. Up more. Okay. All right, right there is good. What was that?
I don't know. What was that?
Okay. What a pain. Ooh. Give me a little bit more slack. A little bit more. A little bit more. A little bit more.
Are you drunk? What's happening?
Hallelujah. We'll be right back and we're gonna try pulling the engine out of the car. And I think
tomorrow we won't be right back. It's gonna be like at least 12
hours. Well, for them, we'll be right back.
Okay.
So we're back and we're getting closer to running our second test. So the first thing we have to do is take the E30 off of these wheel cribs. And once we get this thing lowered and leveled to the ground, we'll be ready for the true test. Kind of a little close there.
Okay.
All right, I think we're ready. Ashley, you ready?
Ready as I'm gonna be.
She's ready. Let's do this. All right, that's good. Okay, start bringing it down. Down one. There it is on the ground. The part that got dicey was when I was swiveling this part here. It's almost like it couldn't take the weight of turning this way, so you probably could only turn it so much. I would say probably no more than like 45 degrees, but we were able to get it out successfully. Now we just have to rebuild the engine and put it back in. If you're interested in our wheel crib video, check that out. We'll put a link in it over here.